main meditation. And for this evening, we will take a very, very simple meditation. Very, very effective meditation. We just continue with what we have just been doing. Just remain aware of the whole body at once as a field of sensation. What is the purpose of that? Is to keep our awareness here and now. Use the sensation of the body as an anchor. To hold the body here and now. It is like the anchor of a boat which holds it in place. So the sensation of the body is an anchor to hold your awareness here and now. That's all there is to the meditation, so continue with that. Let sounds and other sensations come and go. In the midst of thoughts and sensations, just hold to the sensation of the body. Let everything else come and go. Without fighting with it. If you do this long enough as a practice, you find eventually that the sensation of the body disappears. And you remain just as stable awareness itself. No inside, no outside. No high or low. Just stable field of awareness. So just hold to the sensation of the body as long as you can, and one day that will happen. will feel united with all.
И тогава ще се почувствате едно с цялото.
It was said at the beginning that meditation is not a popular subject. But it should be the most popular subject. Why? We know everything through the mind. I experience happiness in the mind. I experience sadness in the mind. I experience the world in my mind. I experience myself in my mind. I experience understanding in my mind. I understand ignorance I experience ignorance in my mind. It's in my mind that I experience the feeling of success. It's in my mind that I experience a failure. It's in my mind that I experience everything. There is no experience outside of mental experience. Our senses bring the world in to us, but we don't experience in the senses, we experience what the senses bring to the mind. So the mind is the instrument of all experience. So if we don't take care of the mind, how can we hope to have good experience? How can we hope to be really happy unless the mind is cultivated? There are various ways in which we can cultivate the mind. But the most direct way is through meditation. And so that's why meditation can have such a profound effect over us. The problem is when we try to meditate, we find the mind doesn't want to cooperate.
Проблемът е, че когато се опитваме да медитираме, откриваме, че умът всъщност не ни съдейства.
We try to focus the mind.
Опитваме се да фокусираме ума си.
And the mind says, no, I want to think about that, I want to think about that.
Но ума казва, не искам да мисля за това или не искам да мисля за това.
And so meditation is difficult.
Затова медитацията е трудна.
And it can only be really cultivated.
И ума може да бъде наистина умен.
If we practice every day, and that is frightening. Already I have so many things to do every day. But every day I brush my teeth without thinking about it. Every day I take a shower without thinking about it. Every day I eat breakfast, lunch, and supper, and maybe I do think about that. And every day I take some rest. I sleep. So the things we do every day without thinking much about it. No matter how busy we are, we try to do those things anyway. There are only occasionally days when we're so busy that we have to forget about eating and we have to forget about other things that we normally do also. But we can't do that for many days, maybe one day here, one day there. And so for meditation, if we can come to it, we should think of it in that way. As something that I need to do every day, that I want to do every day. Another problem is that meditation takes a long time to develop. It takes years, not a weekend. That is frightening also. I have so many things to do, how can I devote time to something that takes years and years to develop well? When I was a child of 5 years old, my little friends told me that next year you'll have to start school. I said, how long do I have to go to school? You have to go for 12 years, at least. I thought, I'm only 5 years old and I've already lived forever. How can 12 years, that's like eternity. And then they said, but then you probably want to go to college, to university. That's at least 4 more years. And if you want to be a doctor, you have to go for several more years. So by that time, I was ready to run away. But we do it. I eventually went to school and I made my way through. And so with meditation. Just as when we go to school, every year we're learning things. It's not that you go to school and spend at least 12 years without learning anything until the very end. All the way you're discovering things. And so with the practice of meditation, all of the way you are improving the quality of your mind. Even if sometimes you don't feel like it. After time, you look back and see that, no, I'm not the same person I was before. And so in meditation practice, what is important is that you do something every day. It's better to take 10 or 15 minutes every day to practice than to start with enthusiasm and say, okay, today I'm going to sit for 2 hours. And then for the next month you don't want to practice anymore. take a little time every day and do what you can do every day. And then you'll find in time that you want to spend more time practicing. And you'll find that throughout the day there are little moments when suddenly you're a little free from engagement in things. And then you think, well, let me come back to myself, let me come back to meditation for just a couple of minutes. And then you feel refreshed. So, one of the reasons for practicing meditation is because it is good for the mind, which is good for all of you. And what I mean by it's good for all of you is that it's good for your whole being. There are side benefits to meditation. And many people practice meditation for the side benefits. And that's okay, that's also good. For some people practice meditation just to reduce stress. Some people practice meditation because the mind is so noisy, I just have to make it quiet a little bit so I get some peace. Some people practice meditation because it makes me more successful in my studies or in my business. Some people practice it because it helps to reduce blood pressure. And all of those things are okay. And if that's all you want from the meditation, then that's okay too. But the real purpose of meditation, the deeper purpose, is much higher than that. So let me give you four metaphors of meditation to explain the benefits of meditation. Three are ancient metaphors, and one is a modern metaphor. I'll start with the modern. As kids, we have all taken a magnifying glass, and caught the rays of the sun to burn a piece of paper. What have we done by taking a magnifying glass? We haven't created anything. The rays of the sun are already falling. All we've done is to focus what's already there down to a point. But when we focus it on a point, it has such power that it can burn and start a fire with paper or leaves. And so the rays of our mind, like the rays of the sun, are right now going in all directions. Thinking of all sorts of things all the time. The mind jumps from thought to thought to thought to thought. And so through meditation, if I can bring the mind into focus, then the mind has tremendous power.
огромна сила.
We've all had the experience of reading reading something.
Всички от всеки от нас има опита да чете нещо.
And I read a paragraph and I come to the end.
Прочитам един параграф и стигам до края.
And I think I don't even know what I just read.
И си мисля, дори не знам какво прочета.
And then I think, okay, let me go back again and I'll read it again.
И си казвам, нека да го прочита отново и започвам от нова.
And again I come to the end of the paragraph.
И отново стигам до края на параграфа.
And I think I did it again. I have no idea what I just read.
Отново аз не знам какво прочета.
Because my mind was thinking about other things. So, if we can learn concentration, then we can apply it wherever we need to. Everything in the universe gives up its secrets through the power of concentration. Everything in the universe.
Всяко нещо във Вселената отстъпва пред силата на концентрацията.
The third chapter of the Yoga Sutras of Patanjali is about the powers of the mind.
Трета глава от Йога Сутра на Патанджали е за силите на ума.
That wherever you focus your mind and put it,
тя казва, там се казва, че навсякъде където концентрираме ума си,
there the that gives up its secrets to us. And that we see in our own experience. Even without developing higher powers of concentration. If I am interested in a subject like gardening, but I don't know anything about it, I have no experience. Then if I begin to put my mind into gardening, I read some information about how to garden, I learn about the climate where I live and what kind of plants will grow well,
какъв климат живея и кои растения ще вирят добре.
I learned when to plant a certain different plants.
Уча за това къде да се дела определени растения.
Which need more water, which need less water.
Това е колко да искат повече или по-малко.
Which need more light, which need some shade.
Това кои растения колко светлина се нуждаят.
Gradually the world of gardening reveals its secrets to me.
Постепенно света на градинарството разкрива своите тайни за мен.
And if I pursue it, I may become a master gardener.
И ако продължавам в това, мога да стана мастер гардинер.
How did that happen?
Как става това?
I went from not knowing anything to now becoming a master gardener.
Тръгнал съм без да зная нищо, без да имам знания, съм станал мастер гардинер.
Just by putting my mind into that field of gardening.
Просто фокусирайки и насочвайки ума си в сюжета, темата на градината.
So in a similar way, the astronomer focuses his mind and puts it through the telescope.
По същия начин астронома концентрира ума си и го насочва към телескопа.
And the heavens reveal their secrets.
И небесата разкриват своите тайни.
The biologist focuses her mind and puts it through the microscope. And the microscopic world reveals its secrets to her. So wherever we can focus our mind and put it, that reveals its secrets. It's a wonderful thing to realize that power of the mind. So that's one metaphor, the metaphor of the magnifying glass. Another metaphor is of a calm lake. all seen pictures of a mountain lake that's extremely calm.
Всеки от нас е виждал снимки на планинско езеро, което е много спокойно.
We sometimes see such photographs in a calendar, for instance.
Виждали сме такива снимки в календар, например.
And sometimes there's a lake with a mountain behind and trees.
И понякога сме виждали снимки с езеро, дървета отзад, планини.
And the mountain and the trees are perfectly reflected in the lake.
И планината и дърветата се отразяват
And when you first look at it, sometimes you're not sure, should I look at it this way or that way? Because the reflection is so perfect. Why is the reflection so perfect? Because there are no waves on the lake. Is perfectly tranquil. So if through meditation we can bring to the mind to that state, where the lake of the mind is not disturbed by any waves, waves of different thoughts and waves of impulses, then we can have a clear view of reality. We can see the truth as it is. That's not what we see now. Now we have a distorted view of everything. Because the mind is in a constant state of disruption by all of the different thinking and thoughts that we have. Modern science has shown that this world is not what it looks like. Science began by several centuries ago in Europe by taking the physical world for granted as true. The world comes to our senses and we know it through the senses and we know it as it is. So it took a very science began with a common sense view of the universe. The world is as we see it. And science just wanted to know how does it work. And so Newtonian physics is just the common sense, the common sense physics of how the world works. But the late 19th century and 20th century, scientists discovered something quite different. Again, by closing their minds and looking closer and closer at nature. They found that the world is not what it looks like. This looks so solid. But it's mostly just empty space. The atoms are charged to nucleus and charged electrons with vast space in between.
Атомите представляват заредени фотони и заредени електрони с огромно пространство между тях.
This is mainly empty space.
Моята ръка е предимно празно пространство.
This is mainly empty space.
Масата също е почти цяло празно.
And matter and energy are just different states of the same thing.
И материята и енергията са просто две различни състояния на едно и също.
So the world that modern science sees now is very different from the So when the mind becomes perfectly calm, and we are able to see reality as it is, we see that nothing is the way that I thought it was. Yes, I can still function, I can still work. But now I begin to understand the secrets of the universe. I begin to understand that I am not separate from you. It's the mind which spreads everything out into space. But everything is right here. And when I say right here, I don't mean everything is inside Swami Atmarupananda. But we are all right here. You are all right here. And we are all right there. Within the heart of everyone. The heart of everyone is in the same place. The whole universe is in within each one of us. So we begin to see that the world is not at all what we thought it was. And that begins to have great benefit to us. So another metaphor is of the calm lake, which allows us to see things as they are. A third metaphor, which is the calm lake is a traditional metaphor, let's see. And a third metaphor, which is traditional, is of pouring oil from one vessel into another. If I pour water from one vessel to another from a little height, it makes noise, it splashes, it breaks into droplets. But when I pour oil from one vessel to another, there's one continuous stream of oil that falls silently into the rest of the oil. So that is said to be the nature of the mind in meditation. When the mind begins to succeed in meditation after long practice, then when we put the mind on any object of meditation, then the mind flows quietly towards that without any break. Now, right now, if we practice meditation, we try to meditate on something, a symbol or whatever, or light, whatever. We picture the object of meditation for a moment. And the mind runs away thinking about other things. And then after a while I realize that I'm thinking about other things and I bring the mind back and say, no, I'm supposed to think about this. And after a few moments the mind starts running after some other thought. And then I realize it, I bring the mind back and say, no, I'm supposed to think about this. So it's hard to hold the mind steady even for 1 second. But after long practice, the
first two